The Bahamas Tonight Northern Edition starts now.
In a developing story from West End, immigration officials have captured several individuals following a foil to smuggling in the western part of the island. Good evening, all. I'm Ramiko Knowles. Thanks so much for tuning in. While speculation about a large group has surfaced, but authorities suspect those numbers may be exaggerated. Raven Davis has tonight's top story.
Two Venezuelans, including a baby, an Italian, and several Haitians, are in custody following a foiled smuggling operation in West End on Tuesday. Chief Immigration Officer in charge of investigations, Rodney Wagus, confirming today that the migrants who initially evaded authorities eventually emerged from the bushes, subsequently being apprehended by immigration and police officials.
We retrieved nine of the persons. And the group that'll be four females and five males. Not include the infant that was along with the group. The infant was made 10 because I don't know how many persons were on the vessel.
Officials reported that the migrants were likely en route to the United States. The vessel involved a small white boat will be confiscated as investigations intensify.
Questioning them along with the police. We're gathering information and we're just taking our investigation further as to who would have taken them down to West End.
And authorities have a clear message for those running these smuggling operations.
Well, taking advantage of these persons who are now desperate, leaving their countries for whatever reasons they may be.
While Goose is still urging residents to remain vigilant and report any suspicious activity they may notice in the West End area.
Contact us and let us know that they have strange persons in their community that we need to be aware of and we need to come and check out.
While speculation circulated online yesterday about the involvement of 30 migrants, Chief Immigration Officer Rodney Wagu suspects that number may be inflated. He confirmed that the search continues as officials work to locate any remaining individuals involved in the operation and facilitate their return home to their respective countries. For the Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition, I'm Raven Davis.
Thanks, Raven. Well, as Grand Bahama braces for a construction boom, industry professionals are sounding the alarm on an issue that they say holds the sector back, hoping to ignite a fire in their young counterparts. Cleopatra Murphy has the story.
A local contractor is lamenting the lack of good young Bahamian labor on construction sites. Deshaun Smith says he unfortunately agrees with Bahamian Contractors Association President Leonard Sands, who cited an increase in foreign labor on construction sites due to poor work ethics among young Bahamian men.
A lot of guys come to you hungry. After 2 weeks, they get comfortable. It's the phone. You know, they're not really trying to work. And so, yeah, I mean, it's a tough industry. It's hard work and sweat. I spend many summers out there as a kid. You know, like I said, pretty much my whole life, so I'm not afraid of work, but you have a lot of guys that don't understand what it takes to get to different levels. And, you know, they don't realize that you could go from being a helper to a semi-skilled guy, to a carpenter, to a superintendent, to a foreman, to a project manager. There's just so many levels to go to, but to get to that point is a lot of work.
Another general contractor, Justin Adderley, believes they are not lazy, but says they need to be pushed.
They encourage them to give the Bahamian men more chances. If, you know, they have short certificate programs for them, to get them more enthused into working in the construction industry, that would be perfect.
With many years in the sector, general contractor Clayton Rowe admits some are lazy, but defends there are many good workers.
There's a lot of work going wrong, and the real good workers are taken up. So we really deal with the scrappings now. So I don't want to call too much of them. Too much of my brothers, I don't want to call them too lazy.
Calling it the age of the microwave generation, Smith says too many young people want immediate rewards, but he is urging them to make the most of opportunities in the sector.
I wish that more young people would really invest more in themselves by way of just taking advantage of the trade, because there's money to be made there, you know, but you have to really develop your skills.
For the Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition, I'm Cleopatra Murphy.
Thanks, Cleo. Well, the Grand Bahama Power Got to Go Committee is urging officials to step out of their corporate offices and engage directly with the community by hosting town hall meetings. They believe the discussions are essential for addressing residents' concerns about rising power bills and the ongoing regulatory issues surrounding the Grand Bahama Power Company. Raven Davis has that story.
A planned press conference in front of the Grand Bahama Power Company disrupted by bad weather. However, members of the GB Power Got to Go Committee are not relenting. Today, they're criticizing the Grand Bahama Port Authority's invitation for online stakeholder input on the power company's rate plan proposal, calling it a slap in the face to residents.
If you can't come and face the people of Grand Bahama in a proper setting, a town hall meeting, answer tough questions, be responsible as the company who supplies the entire island, that's not good. That's not good for the country. It's not good for Grand Bahama.
According to the release, Grand Bahama Power Company has proposed an investment of $8.4 million over the next 3 years to enhance system reliability and efficiency. However, Johnson questions why these funds cannot be sourced from the storm recovery charge.
What have you been doing with that money? And that's being absorbed amount of money they've been making for the backs of Grand Bahamans. Also, you also promised that 2 weeks ago, when you got these generators, but just a pair out of the sky, that there would be no disrupting in power supply. Well, since that's being dishonest, because since that, consumers have complained about power outages consistently again.
And the debate continues over the regulatory authority for the Grand Bahama Power Company, whether it lies with the Utilities Regulation and Competition Authority, or GBPA. This uncertainty fueling growing frustration among residents.
I will really, what the Prime Minister said, the Bahamas does not have two governments. And I want the party to understand that.
Now the consultation period ends on November 4. However, Johnson says he will not respond to that invitation for stakeholder input and discourages other Bahamians from doing so as well. He says officials should come out of their corporate offices and host town hall meetings throughout the island. For the Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition, I'm Raven Davis.
Well, as Junkanoo is quickly approaching, group leaders received the seed funding from the Ministry of Youth Sports and Culture. These leaders say that they are excited to hit the road in the new year. Shalia Roll reports.
As Grand Bahamians anticipate to hear the sounds of the sweet Junkanoo music on New Year's and Majority Rule Day in West End and Explorers Way, Junkanoo group leaders are just as excited to compete for the best Junkanoo group title. In preparation for the big day, all participating groups receive their seed funding. First up receiving their funding of $9,000 is Junkanoo groups in the A category, and they express their excitement about going head to head on Explorers Way.
Time for change.
Oh!
The swimmers is going to bring the change.
We've been growing since motorboat passed, and this year we're going to give you all a show that you all never forget.
You're going to get a treat. And let me let Mr. Swinging over here and Mr. PK here know here that they listen to the rest. Marco, see the best.
Up next, groups in the B division receive their seed funding of $4,000, but with a new route and a new date comes new groups in the category. The leader of the new group says that he's excited to watch and learn from the veterans.
Well, I look forward to seeing the performance. My name is Gennaro Goldbrook. I'm the founder of the newest Junkanoo group on the island. It's called the Bahamian Gladiators Junkanoo group. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be in the category B. Mm-hmm. With the platinum lights.
Ah.
And all the senior members. Now I'm watching because I'm learning.
Now fun groups are not missing out on the Junkanoo Festival. Group leaders say that with no competition comes no stress. These members are receiving their funding of $2,000.
Oh, the Bushwhackers.
Yes.
Everyone knows the Bushwhackers. Yeah. If there's no Bushwhackers, there's no Junkanoo.
Here to eliminate all of the stress that the guys then have to deal with. Yeah. But we'd like to invite all the people there to feel free and come and join us.
Again, the New Year's Day Junkanoo Parade is scheduled to take place on January 1st, 2025 at 3 a.m. And the Majority Rule Junkanoo Parade is scheduled for January 8th, 2025 at 8 p.m. on Explorers Way. For the Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition, I'm Shalia Roll.
And still to come.
When we come back, Grand Bahamians honoring a former minister and West Grand Bahama and Bimini Member of Parliament. That story, sports, and more when the Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition, continues.
you have enough things to worry about. Living in a world that can seem opposite of the things you are trying to accomplish.
I mean, I can need a little help with this process.
We're here to let you know that you don't have to go at it alone. Choose peace of mind. Choose comfort. Choose CB. Commonwealth Bank, leader in personal banking services.
Come on down and see what Dolly Madison has in store for you. Renovate and rejuvenate at Dolly Madison.
Join the Cancer Awareness Health Seminar and Health Fair on Friday, September 27th at the Pro Cathedral of Christ the King Hall. The Health Fair starts at 4 p.m., followed by the seminar at 6 p.m. with keynote speaker Dr. Robin Roberts. Get free screenings and vital health information. The Paint Fair family is excited to announce that they're rolling out to a new location soon. Stay tuned for grand reopening details and special giveaways. In the meantime, they are still operating on West Mall Drive while finishing up the renovations. Miss the Park & Shop sale. Enjoy 25% off store-wide, excluding underwear and red tag items on September 26th, 27th, 28th, and 30th. Plus, check out their 50% off racks with items as low as $10. Store hours are 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monday through Saturday.
It's me, Mama D, inviting you to join me on Sunday, October 13th, 2024 at Sunset Village Fish Fry, 8 Mile Rock for KB and Friends as we celebrate the music and legacy of KB. Get your tickets and beat me there.
It's the Battle of the Brains, 20 years strong and still going. Powered by Grand Bahama Power, fueling the future with scholarships and new opportunities.
I'm Leanna Johns, I'm from LAS, and I want to say thank you to Grand Bahama Power and to Buckeye for giving us this opportunity.
I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to Grand Bahama Power Company and Buckeye for providing us the opportunity to get a scholarship.
The Battle of the Brains, where school pride meets genius.
Number one team in the North. Only the sun covers the Bahamas better.
Welcome back. Today marks the one-year anniversary since the passing of former cabinet minister and a member of parliament for West Grand Bahama and Bimini, the Honorable Obadiah Wilchcombe. Today, his former colleagues remembered his impact to community while regarding him as one of the best journalists to date. Jolanda Thompson-Everest joins us live from a special event in his honor.
That's right, Romika. We are here live at the 8 Mile Rock Gymnasium, where a gospel concert has been planned in honor of the late Obadiah Wilchcombe. A number of musical performances are expected to take place, and residents are slowly coming in. But earlier today, the late minister's parliamentary colleagues honored him in the House of Assembly today.
The legacy of the former Minister of Social Services and Broadcasting and also Member of Parliament for West Grand Bahama and Bimini, the Honorable Obadiah Wilchcombe, continues. His former parliamentary colleagues honoring him in the House of Assembly today, recalling his dual role in government and speaking to his impact to country.
Being the Member of Parliament for West Grand Bahama and Bimini, I have come to know that no matter what happened throughout OB's term as MP, whether good or bad, he has left an indelible mark on the hearts of the people. They will never forget him.
His contributions to our society were profound, impacting various sectors and leaving a legacy that will endure. Obi's journey through life was a remarkable one, characterized by his unwavering charisma and dedication to his country.
He was really, really an icon and a fixture in this honorable place.
Minister Wilchcombe's political career began in 1994. He also served as the Minister for Tourism, introducing sports, religious, and African-American tourism in the Bahamas. The minister also created a platform for the development of a film industry. But beyond his political span, the icon was also a sportsman and a former president of the Grand Bahama Basketball Association.
Obi Wilchcombe was a fixture on behalf of the Progressive Liberal Party at various church services. And so you cannot help, when you go to a convention, remembering that when you were there 2 years ago, 3 years ago, that Obie Wilschkamp was there.
Wilschkamp passed away on September 24th, 2023 in West Grand Bahama at the age of 64. A concert has been planned in his honor tonight with performances by Simeon Alton, Ozzin Jadort, the West End Primary School Band, and more at the 8 Mile Rock High School Auditorium. We are here live at the 8 Mile Rock Gymnasium, where a gospel concert has been planned in honor of the late Obadiah Wilschkamp. A number of musical performances are expected to take place. Residents are slowly coming in, as you can see. But earlier today, the late minister's parliamentary colleagues honored him in the House of Assembly.
Thanks so much, Yolanda. A great report. Well, in other news, a young Bahamian singer from Holmes Rock is about to take center stage, sharing the spotlight with one of gospel's music's biggest names after winning an online competition, that Thruster International Spotlight.
Is the melodic voice of Eden Monroe, a native of 8 Mile Rock, who won an online competition granting her the opportunity to open for one of gospel music's biggest artists, Naomi Rain of Maverick City Music.
It is big. In all honesty, I still trying to soak it in.
Monroe submitted a video of herself singing a powerful rendition of Naomi's hit song, My God Did Not Fail. The video quickly gained traction on Facebook.
I just sent it and I said, okay, if God want me to have this, I can have it. And like the first day, like the likes just was going off. And I was like, it is about to be crazy.
Now she's set to join Naomi Rain and friends at a major concert in the nation's capital early next year. But this isn't the first time she's caught the attention of gospel industry's heavyweights. In July of 2023, she was personally recognized by gospel legend Donnie McKirkland.
Honestly, all I can say is it's just really God. God's hand on my life.
As a young woman walking in faith, Monroe says the pressure to be perfect is constant.
People look at you, you know, with that sharp eye, you know, like, why are you in here, or why are you doing this, or why are you doing that? And you have to be very careful of what you do and where you go, what you post. I would think that pressure is a lot sometimes, because it's like, sometimes you can't do nothing right.
However, that pressure is what drives her, fueling the passion she pours into every song.
This walk with Christ ain't easy, but at the end of the day, God ain't gonna allow you to go through anything. I'll put you in a place where you're not positioned for it.
That's a look at stories making news. Jay, tell us what's happening in sports.
Amico, you're witness in Georges, right?
That's right, I'm a Jaguar.
Did you play volleyball back then?
A little bit.
They might need you now, because yesterday, man, LIS was dominant the whole time.
Jaguars, you gotta do better than that. Well, I will check on that, but first you check on weather.
Weather forecast is brought to you by Royal Star Assurance.
Because it's a beautiful
news in the making? Call us at 352-9713 or 359-5167, or you can email us at zns3news@gmail.com.
Journey to a serene oasis. Relax. Rejuvenate.
One of the biggest decisions you will make when remodeling a kitchen is the design choice for your kitchen cabinets. Whether you want your kitchen to look modern or traditional, the Casablanca White Shaker cabinets will make a sound choice. Stop into Conrad Bahamas today and let them enhance your kitchen with the Casablanca White Shaker cabinets. At Conrad Bahamas, they also carry an array of Calicata quartz countertops. Conrad Bahamas, Sandyport, Nassau, Freeport, Grand Bahama, Abaco, and Eleuthera.
Freeport, get ready to witness the talent explosion of the year. It's Freeport's Got Talent. Three epic nights, September 27th through the 29th at Port Lacayo Marketplace, starting at 7 p.m. Bring the entire family and come see the best of Freeport's rising stars, who will walk away with a grand prize. This is a competition you don't want to miss. Admission is free. Brought to you by Grand Bahama Port Authority.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm self-insuring my investments, starting with this tarp.
We all remember the blue tarps after the storm. Let's make sure that we are covered with more than a tarp. Don't allow your investment to be at risk. Protect your investment with one of our insurance policies.
Nobody, nobody, nobody,
nobody does it better.
Jay Champagne and DeRidham presents 102.7 DeRidham turns three, and it's a big performance with Taurus Riley live. Taurus Riley live. Oh yeah, the hitmaker, the reggae icon, Taurus Riley live. Saturday, December 14th at the Grand Lucayan Ballroom. Doors open at 8 p.m. Showtime at 11 p.m. For 102.7 DeRidham. Big birthday party with Taurus Riley. Live. Get tickets online now. DeRidham3.com. And it's a big performance. Taurus Riley. Brought to you by Jay Champagne and DeRidham. Saturday, December 14th. 102.7 DeRidham. Turns three with Taurus Riley. Live.
Good evening, ladies and gents. I'm Jay Philippe, and welcome to sports. First in sports, Yavin Butler Volleyball Tip-Off Classic got underway yesterday at St. George's Gym. In the opening match in girls' play, the defending champions, LIS, easily took care of Jack Hayward in two straight sets, 21-9 and 21-11, to move on to the next round.
Well, I told the girls after the game, I said, hey, the young ladies on the other side never really scored on you guys. So pretty much the scores that they got was pretty much from your mistakes. So let's go back to the drawing board and let's see if we can fix those mistakes.
I feel like we did really well. We tried to work as a team. We were all there for each other, just being encouraging. So, yeah, I think we did our best.
The runners-up last year, the Sunland Stingers got the win against the Blue Jays out of 8 Mile Rock in three sets, 19-8, 19-13, and 15-5.
We lost the first set and I was a bit disappointed, but after, you know, the girls get back there, you know, they get the chemistry back together and they put all the skills that they have been working on for the entire preseason, and now we can say that we're super happy for the win today.
They did overall very well. It was good to see that they got relaxed into the second set and did their absolute best, which brought us home a win.
Now in boys' play, Sunland defeated 8 Mile Rock in three sets, 19-14, 19-9, and 15-12. The other boys' matchup had LIS winning against Jack Hayward in two sets, 19-5 and 19-15. Sticking with volleyball scores, this time from Abaco at the high school level, Patrick J. Bethel defeated SC Bootle in two sets in junior girls' action. In junior boys' play, SC Bootle got the win against Forest Heights in two sets. And in senior boys' play, Forest Heights in an upset got the W against Patrick J. Bethel in two sets. And finally in sports, Jonquel Jones and the New York Liberty beat the Atlanta Dream 91-82 on Tuesday night and advanced to the semifinals of the WNBA playoffs. Jonquel Jones had a monster game with 20 points, 13 rebounds for the top seed Liberty, who swept the best of three series and will face Las Vegas Aces in the next round that begins on Sunday. And that's your Wednesday check on sports. I'm Jay Philippe. Your Facebook friend is up next. Be blessed.
Need to save. Save time, gas, and money. Shopping at Save More can help you do just that. Make us your first stop for all your prescription needs and medical supplies. Get all your health and beauty items at the same time. And don't miss our huge choice of snacks to satisfy your cravings. And the largest vitamin selection and over-the-counter relief products. Need diapers and other baby care items? First stop. The new section for makeovers, cosmetics, and beautiful jewelry will make you sparkle for that next special event. Save More Drugs, your more store.
Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Fonte, representative for the Provision Band Boys right now.
This is Jason, JMC Entertainment Providenciales.
It's your boy, Super PV Entertainer, all the way from the Turks and Caicos Islands.
Asking you guys to join me on the 13th of October
at Sunset Village.
It's 8 Mile Rock.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're celebrating the life, the legacy, the music
of KV. Get your tickets and beat us there.
It's going to be a great time. Join me there.
Don't meet me there. Beat me there. Let's go.
Hi, I'm Derek Stubbs.
And I'm Cindy Russell. Zenonist 810 AM presents
Grand Bahama. Get ready for the event of the year. Experience a live recording of one of the Bahamas' leading gospel ensembles, Shabbat, on stage with some of gospel's greats, along with the Grand Bahama Gospel Community. Sunday, National Heroes Day weekend, October 13th, 7 p.m., Jubilee Cathedral, East Settlers Way. It's a free event. Don't miss an experience of a lifetime.
But it doesn't stop there. You can be a part of the largest music workshop and coming together the island's best in creative arts. Register today by scanning here or get an application from your local church. The Grand Bahama Music Workshop begins Wednesday, October 9th at 7 p.m. nightly through Friday, the 11th. Sessions for choir members, praise teams, dancers, musicians, sound technicians, and media operators. The nightly sessions followed by a mass choir rehearsal to record special songs at Shabbat's live recording.
Here at Freeport Decorators, we have hundreds of products for you to choose from. Whether you're in the market for trophies, plaques, rubber stamps, corporate signs, any kind of interior signage, stamps, or seals, we're your one-stop shop. We feature glass, acrylic, crystal awards for every occasion. We build all the trophies here on site. Looking for a gift item? We feature pens, key rings, mugs, tumblers, barbecue tools, even bamboo cutting boards. Have something already? Bring it on down. Let us see if we can print that special something on it for you. Need a headstone? Memorialize the memory of your loved one with a beautifully lasered granite marker. Our store hours are Monday to Friday, 9 to 5. We focus on customization. So if you have an idea or a new concept, bring it on down or call us at 352-5557 or even WhatsApp your idea to us at 646-0777 and we will do our best to make your awards and recognition ideas a reality.
Your number one team in the North. Only the sun covers the Bahamas better.
The Bahamas tonight, the Northern Edition, on behalf of the entire news team here in the North. I'm Ramiko Knowles. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to stay tuned. The Bahamas Tonight continues.
News is brought to you by the new BTC. Fiber is here, faster, stronger, more reliable. Together, we are unstoppable. Switch today.
Coming up in the Bahamas tonight, claims of a senior officer's transfer amid a high-profile corruption probe dismissed. Also, the constitutionality of proposed amendments, the focus of debate in the House of Assembly, with the Prime Minister and Leader of Opposition locking horns. And when saving becomes difficult. The story of many Bahamians in the face of increasing bank fees. Hear what the chairman of the Clearing Banks Association has to say about it. The Bahamas Tonight, the National Report, starts now. everyone, and welcome to the broadcast. A sentencing in the courts, not sitting well with some members of the public. Joel Strawn, a man in his 20s, found guilty of burglary and rape, given what one opposition senator charges is a light sentence, given the gravity of the crime. Our Danielle Dean spoke with the Minister of National Security on the issue.
A 9-year sentence given to a serial burglar and a man who committed multiple violent crimes against women, including the 2023 rape of an 83-year-old woman. National Security Minister Wayne Monroe responds to a press statement by FNM Senator Michael Barnett Ellis, who says she is appalled and outraged by the unduly low sentence given to Joel Strawn, who is in his early 20s.
If this is a matter involving a plea agreement, a request should be made from the office of the DPPS for the reason for the plea agreement. The law permits them to have to tell the victim that. The law permits them to be able to speak to the victim to say, we're about to enter a plea agreement. These are the terms. What do you think of it? Plea agreements can be influenced by the strength or otherwise of evidence. I do not have sufficient facts to be able to evaluate the matter. But a request can be made of the office of the DPP for what was the justification for them agreeing to that particular plea agreement.
Minister Monroe cites weak evidence as an example of why suspects may receive a lesser sentence or even get off scot-free, adding that in order to properly evaluate the efficiency of sentences, persons must know the justification given.
There are a number of cases that people don't plead to, and then they're acquitted. The acquittal rate in sexual offenses is very high. So if there is an evaluation by the officers of DPP that in order to get a guaranteed conviction, in order to spare an 84-year-old lady from having to go through the trauma of going back in court and reliving that trauma, they determine that that's appropriate, that would be a matter to inquire of the DPP. The FNM government is the one who removed this authority from the AG, a political appointee, and gave it to an independently appointed DPP for this exact reason.
Monroe says crime concerns not only the Ministry of National Security, but the public and every agency of government, and vows to continually work towards its reduction. Danielle Dean reporting for The Bahamas Tonight.
Meantime, rumors and misinformation today swirling about a senior cop under intense investigation. Tonight, our Devante Hanna tells us what the police spokesperson had to say on the issue that has left tongues wagging. Devante?
Well, Makushalo Police Press Liaison Chief Superintendent Chrisling Skippings is tonight refuting those claims that Michael Johnson has been transferred, and she's making it clear that he remains on guarding leave. Now, the speculation erupted after a photo of Royal Bahamas Police Force internal document made its way on social media, and that document was labeled transfer, in which it ignited a firestorm of rumors. Sources extremely close to the matter tells ZNS Johnson reports to headquarters now and that he has been placed on leave. Now, of course, this is all a part of the normal procedure when it comes to instances like this. Now, the former head of CID remains at the center of a deepening probe fueled by leaked voice notes where he seemingly tried to quash an investigation into that armored truck robbery that occurred last year. Chief Superintendent Skippings said this.
The document further highlights Chief Superintendent Johnson transfer to the office of the commissioner with effect from Monday, the 8th of July, 2024. The Commissioner of Police wishes to remind members of the public that the investigation into the voice notes are ongoing and that Chief Superintendent Johnson remains on garden leave and will remain until the conclusion of the investigation.
Of course, adding another layer to that controversy is a viral photo in which both Chief Superintendent Skippings and Johnson can be seen together on the crime scene. Now being used to suggest that Johnson is still on active duty despite what police have previously said. But in a firm statement, Skippings denied that the photo was recent. And of course, that investigation is still ongoing. And according to the Commissioner of Police, it could be completed by the end of the year. He says, though international investigators have yet to arrive in country, they have been involved in the probe led by the Security and Intelligence Branch of the police force. Mukushlo.
Well, thanks, Devontae. Meantime, a dozen policemen summoned to the coroner's court last week made a second appearance before coroner Kara Turnquist's vote today. The matter stemming from a number of police-involved shootings. Fern Carey reports that family members of the deceased were not at all happy with today's outcome.
The cases of 12 police officers involved in matters before the coroner's court, where jurors returned homicide by manslaughter verdicts, have all been adjourned to November 15th of this year. The attorney marshaling the case from the Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions informed Coroner Kara Turnquist DeVoe that he had been in contact with the Director of Public Prosecutions, who indicated that although the process has started, there are other cases she's looking at this time, and the cases involving the officers will be addressed at a later date. He then suggested that the cases be adjourned to January of 2025, prompting the coroner to ask if an earlier date was not available given the nature of the cases. All sides then agreed on the adjourned date of November 15th at 11 a.m. These matters date back to March of 2022 up to July of this year, involving deceased persons Azaria Major, D'Angelo Evans, Shantan Forbes, Valentino Johnson, Gino Finley Jr., and Elron Stubbs. Now, also during the proceedings, a warrant of arrest remained in place for three officers who did not show up at court. That includes an officer who is reportedly on the run.
Family members are not happy with this adjournment as they feel that this case is not being given priority.
Why are police officers not treated like every other criminals who are charged with matters such as these?
That's right.
Why police officers are not given on monitors, ankle monitors to put on their legs, and their passport be taken away?
Yes.
You see, because you see, the people don't understand. All of these families are living in fear.
Yes.
Because we are standing up for what is right.
Meantime, all 12 police officers remain out on $9,500 bail. For the Bahamas Tonight, I'm Fern Carey.
Well, thanks, Fern. Still to come, head of the Clearing Banks Association talks bank fees and profits. Stay with us. You're watching the Bahamas Tonight.
At Commonwealth Bank, we offer affordable and flexible choices to get you back to financial fitness. Our personalized debt consolidation solution is built to fit any financial situation. One easy-to-handle monthly payment reduces your monthly expenses and gets you back on track to savings. Life is great when you're not weighed down by debt. Consolidate and live your best life with Commonwealth Bank, your leader in personal banking services.
With BTC's crystal clear mobile service, stay connected seamlessly, whether on land or at sea. Our reliable postpaid plans keep your loved ones closer, no matter where life takes you.
Licking good.
Do you know a fisher who braves the seas every day, bringing home a catch that feeds our communities? Nominate them now for the Anchor Awards, a night dedicated to celebrating the unsung heroes of our waters. On November 16th at the Bahama Resort, we're shining a spotlight on those who make waves, both big and small. Visit the Ministry of Agriculture and Marine Resources Facebook page and click on the link provided to submit your nomination. Let's give our fishers the recognition they deserve. Anchor Awards 2024.
Come celebrate the PayFast Live Digital campaign. Get ready to learn all about digital payments and embrace the future of finance. Ditch the old and say hello to new, faster and safer ways to pay. So join us, check in with your personal bank, credit union or digital wallet provider to learn everything you need to know about going digital. To learn more, visit us online at livedigitalbahamas.com and on social media. The future of pay is digital.
Portion of the news is brought to you by Bahamas Striping Group of Companies.
You're looking at a live shot of Saunders Beach just off West Bay Street. In news from Parliament, years after the law was passed, the National Crime Intelligence Agency, the body entrusted with providing intel, warning of potential threats and opportunities, and standing ready to take action, only recently secured its own building, vehicle, and its agents trained. National Security Minister, the Honorable Wayne Munro's making that public as he moved debate on amendments to the law that would, among other changes, see the NCIA's name change to reflect the deletion of the word crime. A National Intelligence Agency three-member commission will also be introduced. All in all, uncontroversial as far as he sees things. But opposition leader Michael Pintard is not so convinced, and at the crux of his argument, the constitutionality of the proposed amendments.
Member for Kidd Island, in discussing the next version of the bill that was brought when we were in the chair, the bill was 2019, in discussing that bill and in his contribution, Madam Speaker, the member pointed out that he had very serious concerns about the bill. In summary, the member for Kidd Island indicated that the bill was unconstitutional.
Outrightly rejecting the criticism, Prime Minister the Honorable Philip Davis acknowledges the proposed amendments do not change much outside of ensuring that the law is effective. It's not, he said, whether it's constitutional, at least not now.
We need to be able to identify the structure, which you'll see in the bill. We need to hire persons to fill the various posts that we are now identifying. And we need to ensure that it's properly set up. And this agency will be working with allied agencies around the world. It will help with transnational crime, particularly trafficking of guns, trafficking of persons, drug trafficking. And you note that the word crime has been taken out of the name, because, you know, crime and criminal activities and detection and prosecution of crime is in the remit of the Royal Bahamas Police Force.
MPs also dedicated time to remembering their fallen colleague, Obadiah Walshcombe. We'll have more on that in our 11 p.m. newscast with our Royston Jones. Well, the Bahamas this week joining several of its CARICOM neighbors in ongoing efforts to stop the illegal movement of firearms into our country. But Corval Pyfrom reports on why the Bahamas might have some catching up to do.
Citing a recent study published by the United Nations, the National Security Minister highlighted the price tag illegal firearms cost this country.
Firearms-related cost to this country amounts to 4.8%.
On another news, Clearing Banks Association Chair Gowan Bow giving some insight into the recent increase in banking fees, and he's attributing it to the fact that local bankers suffered significant loss since the COVID-19 pandemic. In fact, Bow says the industry has just regained its footing for the first time in nearly two decades. His comments coming during his appearance on the ZNS talk show, The Rundown, with Clint Watson, during which he sought to defend the increases, at the time lamenting that banks have faced twin calamities in the face of affording its day-to-day operations while attempting to manage a loss in revenue.
Well, you had 2 years of the COVID, and you said, but you're now back to profits. But I have to first replace those losses, because no one came to me when I made the loss and said, well, you know those fees that you didn't charge me?
Correct.
Here's that fee back.
Right.
You go and plug the hole with the losses. Persons are saying, absorb the losses, big bad bank. And then when you make profits, don't charge me the fees. But it doesn't work that way, because my shareholder is me and you. My right. shareholder said, I put my money at risk, and I want my management to be responsible. I want them to take a return. And don't look at 1 year, 2 year. Look at what is going to happen over 15. And I said, profitability from 2008 is just now returning.
Bo says efforts continue to educate customers about digital banking.
We kind of know it, but we don't always appreciate the value of it. So using your debit card and credit card, but also educating you to say that, you know, businesses can't charge you a fee for using your debit or credit card. understanding what it means to be online banking, the audit trail, the dual-factor authentication, the PIN, and not sharing that. Mm-hmm. So it's not just a matter of, like I said, sort of pushing people towards digital. It's showing what are the improved benefits of doing things in a digital way that also will combat some of this concern about fees.
Stay with us. On the Beat is after the break.
Marco's, the pizza that's perfect for every party, every moment, and every occasion.
One of the biggest decisions you will make when remodeling a kitchen is the design choice for your kitchen cabinets. Whether you want your kitchen to look modern or traditional, the Casablanca White Shaker cabinets will make a sound choice. Stop into Conrad Bahamas today and let them enhance your kitchen with the Casablanca White Shaker cabinets. At Conrad Bahamas, they also carry an array of Calacatta quartz countertops. Conrad Bahamas, Sandyport, Nassau, Freeport, Grand Bahama, Abaco, and Eleuthera.
Ago, the Bahamas Striping Group of Companies was birthed out of a passion to change the way we travel. From only a $5,000 grant, the tenacity and work ethic has propelled BSGC to one of the leading road management companies in the Caribbean. We pride ourselves on going the extra mile where others won't, through the use of our state-of-the-art equipment and our certified team. Although the success is commendable, the road has been long. Yet, the mission continues in striving to be a world-class organization ran by Bahamians for Bahamians. With the help of our experienced and hardworking team, we at the Bahamas Striping Group of Companies are committed to making a difference, one road at a time.
Introducing the Focal Smart Pass app that helps you to fuel up faster. Here's how it works. Download the app on the App Store or get it on Google Play and create your profile with payment details. Visit your nearest Shell station, open the app, scan the pump's QR code, select your payment amount, and begin fueling. Say goodbye to cash and cards because the Focal Smart Pass offers secure and convenient payment options right at your fingertips. Download Focal Smart Pass now and fuel up faster today.
And up the news is brought to you by Focal Smart Pass, the smart way to pay at the pump.
Welcome back. A leading voice in the financial services industry is calling on Bahamians, particularly men, to save money and reduce borrowing. In this week's Consumer Tips, Chief Executive Officer of Fidelity Bank, Gowan Bo, offers important tips to achieve financial independence.
While the local economy continues to grow with robust activity within tourism and financial services, the sad reality is that there are some Bahamians not feeling the economic boom. A staggering number still struggling to make ends meet with monthly earnings insufficient to cover their living expenses. CEO of Fidelity Bank, Gowan Bo, says it's now time for Bahamians, particularly men, to examine their financial situation and take ownership of their financial future.
The male wants to be seen as the baller, that's maybe a long old school term, but wants to be seen as the person that has means, wants to be seen as the individual that has a nice vehicle, that has nice clothes, shoes, jewelry. And, you know, whether that's a mating ritual or simply, you know, a status symbol in life, sometimes we get overwhelmed by what is the image that we want to project, not appreciating that financial stability, ambition, advancement and development are far more attractive than simply the flash that doesn't have much at the end of the day.
An analysis of a recent financial survey by the central bank revealed that by gender, 47% of males reported that they are more satisfied when they save money as opposed to spending it, while 25% indicated that they are more satisfied spending now than saving for the long run. In terms of women, a higher 51% preferred to save for the long term than spend money now, whereas 21% saw the reverse as more satisfying.
It's really IPD. Information prioritization and discipline. Mm. We need to know the information around our income and our expenditure and in granular detail, because sometimes we spend on things we don't have an appreciation for, and I mentioned them. Nights at the club, specialty coffee, the latest Android or iPhone device, the latest in terms of technology, etc., when functionally there are much more economical alternatives.
Tracking your financial expenses is also important to achieve your financial goals. Experts recommend that you budget regularly and make managing your finances a matter of habit. For your financial consumer tips, Desmond Saunders, The Bahamas Tonight.
Well, it's about that time when we check in with LaDawn and Marcellus, who joins us live to give us a sneak peek of our new show, Access Now. Guys?
Makushla, did you know that today is National Daughters Day? I know you and both Marcellus both have daughters, so
That's correct.
Hope you guys treat them after the show this evening. Are you guys going to do it?
She gets too much treatment as it is now. You don't need nothing extra.
Makushla, I'm sure your daughters
they should have treat your daughter. I'm not even going to go there, but anyway.
Marcellus, give in. Yeah. Well, stay with us. Our feature story is up next.
All right, team. As a business, it is important for us to save money so y'all can get raises, bonuses, and maternity leave with pay. We need to become an energy-efficient business. Suggestions?
Plant trees outside. It'll help to keep the building cool and clean the air. Stop the heat before I hit the window.
But we have curtains and blinds, though.
That's true. Strike one.
Okay. Laptops save more energy than desktops, because desktops always plugged in. Plus, laptops have energy saving mode.
But I used to be on my laptop all day, and I still used to be exhausted. So how that supposed to save us any energy?
That's true. Strike two. You talk.
Go paperless.
That's a great one. I need to write that down. Pen. Give me the pen. How you think with these things, young man?
I just that good, boss.
SBDC encourages you to save energy and money.
Are you or a loved one under medical care? Do you need affordable medical supplies? Ports International is the largest home health care supplier. Medical supplies at the very best price. And you can even shop online. From hospital beds to wound care, wheelchairs to walkers, Ports is a one-stop shop for your medical supplies, and we accept insurance. We have online shopping and two locations to serve you. At the Airport Industrial Park and Shirley Street. We also ship to the Family Islands. Shop online and visit us on Facebook. Call Ports at 377-1771.
SHSS Electrical has relocated. You can now find them on Chesapeake Road in the former Minute Muffler building. There, you can pick up Square D switches, combos, breakers, and breaker panels, plus all the electrical wires you need. Want meter cans, LED bulbs, and ceiling fans? You can find it all at SHSS Electrical.
Need a DNA test to find out if someone is your father, your child, or your grandparent? Call DNA Direct at 324-0665. Get a DNA test for as low as $450. Now you can prove that you are or are not related to an individual easily. Call DNA Direct 324-0665.
At Audio Plus, you can buy musical equipment like speakers, amps, and mixing boards, plus instruments like drums, horns, and keyboards. No other place in town gives you all the sound equipment you need to get you rocking. And with prices so affordable to all, you'll thank me. Audio Plus, Soldier Road, dial 394-6668.
It's Water Wednesday at Eva Hilton Primary, an initiative designed to encourage students to drink only water throughout the school day. Our West Calix Forbes has more on what Water Wednesday is all about.
Water is very essential and is key to regulating the body's temperature to help maintain bodily function. Did you know you lose water by simply breathing, sweating, and digesting? Hence, it's essential for you to ensure that you rehydrate. In fact, the body is composed of 60% of water, and it's essential that children from an early age know the benefits. Vice Principal of Eva Hilton Primary School and colleagues wanted to find a unique and quick way for students to adapt to the habit of drinking water.
Water Wednesday is an exciting initiative that we have here at Eva Hilton Primary School, and it is something that we would have started to encourage our little ones to drink more water. One of the things that we noticed with them coming back off of the pandemic is that they were a little sluggish, they were a little slow in their movements, and we felt as though it was very important for them to begin to adopt healthy lifestyles.
Research shows that proper hydration can also lead to better academic performances, as students are more alert and engaged in their studies.
Building and ensuring that our children begin healthy lifestyles at this very young age, we feel as though is mandatory and it is important, and it is necessary for us as gatekeepers of our youth to begin to teach our children these healthy lifestyles.
By the end of the day, students not only enjoy the refreshing break from the sweet drinks, but they also learn the valuable lessons of water.
It hydrates your body and it makes you smarter.
You start drinking water, it helps you and it keeps you hydrated.
Being hot in the sun, I drink water and it makes me hydrated.
It makes you feel healthier when you drink more because if you don't drink more, you'll die.
You heard it from the babes themselves. For the Bahamas Tonight, I'm Wes Calix Forbes. Oh, great story there, Wes. And that does it for the National Report, but stay close. The Bahamas Tonight continues with Access Now.